The unit digit of a number, if you consider 123, here 3 is called the unit digit of that number. If you consider an expression like 12 multiplied by 54, if you want to find the unit digit, there is no need to multiply this number. You just simply multiply the unit digit of these two numbers, so you will get 8. Similarly, if you take some bigger number like 12 multiplied by 54 multiplied by 76, if you want to find the unit digit of this expression, now you see the first two numbers, if you multiply, the unit digit is 8. So you can simply multiply 8 into 6, because the unit digit of these two numbers is 8, so 8 into 6. This is the easier way of solving. So 6 into 8 is 48. Again, you will get 8 as an unit digit. But sometimes we will get numbers like 2 power 102 and 2 power 200 and 3 power 102, numbers like this. So in this case, how do you find the unit digit? So first I'll discuss the shortcut technique, how to find the unit digit of expressions like this, and then we will discuss the concept behind how this shortcut actually work. So let us focus on the shortcut first. So for any number, it should end with 1 to 9 digits, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So for numbers 0, 1, 5, 6, whatever power you raise it to, here whatever be the power, if a number ends with 0 or 1 or 5 or 6, you will get the same unit digit, 0, 1, 5 and 6. So this is easy, right? For 0, 1, 5, 6, you will get the same unit digit. You just check 10 square is 100, 10 cube is 1000, you always get 0 as its unit digit. Similarly, if you consider 11, 11 power 1 is 1, the unit digit is 1, 11 square is 121, again the unit digit is 1 here. Similarly, if you take 15 square, 15 cube, you always get 5 as unit digit, similarly for 6. Now we focus on two more numbers, 4 and 9. If 4 power is an odd number like 1, 3, 5, 7, you will get 4 as unit digit. If the power is an even number, so like 2, 4, 6, 8, so the number which is divisible by 2, then you will get 6 as unit digit. Similarly for 9, if the power is an odd number, you will get the same number as unit digit. So if you get 9, so again you will get 9. And if you get, if the power is an even number, then you will get 1 as an unit digit. So if the power is an even number, you will get 1 as unit digit. Now we focus on 4 more numbers. Now we left with only 2, 3, 7 and 8. So for these 4 numbers, we have to follow a simple technique. First, you check whether the power is a 4 multiple or not. Right? Simply divide the power by 4 and check whether the power is divisible by 4 or not. For example, 2 power 200. So when you divide 200 by 4, the remainder is 0. So that is exactly divisible by 4. Or another way you can check the divisibility for 4 is you can just divide the last 2 digits by 4. So 0, 0 is exactly divisible by 4. So when the power is exactly divisible by 4, then you will get 6 as an unit digit. So when the power is a multiple of 4, then you will get 6 as an unit digit. Just you have to memorize this. Similarly for 3, if the power is a 4 multiple, you will get 1 as an unit digit. Similarly for 7, when the power is a 4 multiple, you will get 1 as unit digit. For 8, you will get 6. So always remember, for 2 and 8, both are even numbers, so you will get even number 6 as unit digit. For 3 and 7, which are odd numbers, so when they rise to the power of 4, you will get 1 and 1, so which is an odd number. Now, when you divide these numbers by 4, So first we checked whether they are multiple of 4. That means the remainder is 0. If the remainder is 0, you have to put 6, 6, 1 and 1. But for the other remainders like 1, 2, 3, so you will get only 3 more remainders, 1, 2, 3. So 2 power 1 you will take, you will get 2. Simply write 2 power 1, 2. Simple. So then 2 square, which is equal to 4. When the remainder is 2, simply you can write 2 square. So whatever be the number, if the remainder is 2, simply write 2 square. So 4 will become the unit digit of that expression. For example, in this case, 2 power 102, when you divide this power by 4, you will get 2 as an unit digit. Therefore, you can simply write 2 square, therefore 4 as the unit digit. Here in this case, 2 power 200, when the power is exactly divisible by 4, so you can write 6 as an unit digit, 6. Now, for 2 cube, you have to write 8. Right, so if it is exactly divisible, you will get 6. So for 3, 3 power 1, 3, simply you can write 3 square, 3 into 3, 9, 3 cube, 3 square into 3, so 3 into 9, 27, so you will get 7 here. And for 7, 7 power, which is a 4 multiple, then you will get 1, 7 power 1, 7, and 7 square, 49, 7 cube, 343, or you can directly multiply 9 into 7, which is equal to 3. And for 8, 8 power 1, 8, 8 square, 64, 8 into 8, 64, 8 cube, 4 into 8, 32, so you will get 2 here. So this is a simple table, you just memorize, there is no need to memorize, simply you have to understand how this pattern work. Now we will see how this logic actually work. So to understand this logic, consider multiplication by 6. Suppose when you multiply a number, an even number 0 by 6, what you will get? 0. When you multiply 6 with 2, what you will get? Again, you will get 2. When you multiply 6 by 4, you will get 4. 6 by 6, this is always 6. And 6 by 8, you will get 8 here. You will see here, if you are multiplying an even number with 6, you are getting the same unit digit. This is a very, very important property, right? Now, for example, to understand how this work, the logic work, how the cyclicity work, let us take a simple number 2 power 10. Okay, what we are doing here? We are just dividing this power by 4 and finding the remainder. So what we are doing here is, when you divide this number by 4, you will get 2 power 4 whole square multiplied by 2 square, right? So that is what we are getting. Now what is 2 power 4? 2 power 4 is 16. When the power is a 4 multiple, you will get 6. So we are getting 6 square multiplied by 2 square. Now here 6 square equal to 36 and multiplied by 4. So we know that 4 multiplied by any number is always results in 4. So this is the logic behind why we are doing like this. So even though how big this number is, let us say 2 power 102. So even if you take 2 power 102, the logic is simple. So this is nothing but 2 power 4 whole power 25. Here the quotient is not at all important. So our focus is only on the remainder. So because whatever be the here the power is, that means this 25 or whatever be the quotient, this term always results in the unit digit of 6 only. So 6 multiplied by 4, again we will get 4. That's why this remainder is very, very important. Now you think, why when the multiple is 4, you are getting 6? Because this term was not there. So this, you will get only 6. So 6 power anything again will give you 6. So in this case, let us say 2 power 200. When you write this number as 2 power 4 whole power 25, right? Now 2 power 4 is 6. 6 power anything is again 6. So that is why we are getting 6. Similarly, you can use this logic for, you just take some different numbers and check how this is working. Similarly, for odd numbers, most of the odd numbers like 3, 7, 9, when you raise them to certain power, they results in 1. We know that 1 multiplied by any number always results in 1. So that is a basic logic, right? So odd numbers when raise it to a certain power results in 1. What are those numbers? 3, 7 and 9. For example, if you want to find 3 power 102. So what we are doing here is, so 3 power 4 whole power something k, that is not important. My focus is only on the remainder part, which is equal to 3 square. Now 3 power 4 is 81. So 1 power k is nothing but 1. Now 3 square equal to 9. That's why we are getting 9 here. So 3 power 102, the unit digit is 9. So this is the logic behind why this actually this shortcut logic really work.